to the Felger Mazz Big Board. Our Big Board and exclusive draft coverage is brought to you by the Peterson School, drafting the hardest working people in the trades in Woburn, Westwood, and now Worcester. Classes enrolling now at petersonschool.com. And for more in-depth analysis, breaking news, and mock drafts, go to 985thesportshub.com/draft. Our guys Matt Doloff, Alex Barth, and Ty Anderson have it covered all through the NFL draft, which is fast approaching. And again, there's these great little video vignettes. What am I trying to say?
Summations? Synopsis is the word you're looking for.
Jeez, Felger.
Your synapses, a little gaps in your neural system.
No, I knew it, right? What is the word again?
Synopsis. Plural would be synopses.
The synopses. Tremendous job by Doloff, Barth. These guys, Jim Louth, put those together. Those are on our socials and on the website, so we can catch up on the big board through those videos. Also want to thank Kelly Anderson, our promotions director, for putting together an official, you know, professional-looking big board with all of the selections so far. You know, much better than my usual hackery, my, you know, dime store cut and pasting. She actually did it right. So we'll take a picture of this and blast out everyone that's on the big board to this point.
It's a beauty.
Okay. So we've got, we're counting now. We've only got three positions left. We've got tight ends today, receivers tomorrow, which I'm suddenly horny for. And then, of course, quarterbacks on Thursday.
Yep. Money positions.
So these,
except for these clowns.
I don't think tight ends really, it better not be in the cards.
God, I hope not.
I mean, you draft two last year, can't play. You pay through the nose for the two best in free agency this year. Like, please give us a break with the tight end thing already. But knowing Bill, he'll draft like three of them, right? So let's put some on the board. I've opened up to the secondary pages because I don't want any, you know, chance of you hitting pits. Because that'd just be a waste, right?
Completely.
Okay, here we go. Page two of the Athlon. Murray, go ahead. Don't hit me or the equipment. Usual thing. Go ahead.
Here we go. Fastball. Ooh, good throw, Murray. Right above the red line on the right side.
I got it.
All right, just making sure.
Brevin Jordan. Of the University of Miami. Okay, put him on the board.
Bill was down there for the pro day.
Okay, that's right. He sure was. Brevin Jordan.
That's all about the U.
Okay, it was a good throw, Murray. Go ahead, Mass. No glasses today. Another good throw.
I hit the pitcher.
You hit the pitcher. Okay. Well, that is Tony Poljan. Tony Poljan.
Spell it.
P-O-L-J-A-N.
Poljan.
Poljan.
I don't know. I'm just guessing.
No. That's a good throw. You guys are getting better at throwing these things.
I said it like I knew it, though.
Where day one, Maz takes out a TV monitor.
It's been fixed, by the way.
I tell you, they replaced it. But since then, you guys have been on the money. I got to tell you. All right, last throw, Murray. Go ahead.
Okay, Murray, here you go, pal. Drill it hard. Yeah. Oh, nice throw.
That hit the
bottom right, same spot as last time. One of those two.
Murray nailed it. Good throw.
It's a green, like, 12.
Nice, got it. I'm giving it to you. Right, Nick Eubanks.
I don't know, in relation to Bob?
Nick Eubanks, University of Michigan. Put him on the board. May I speak for a second?
Okay, there you go. Bob. Most people wouldn't get the Bob Eubanks reference. If they draft a tight end at any point in this draft, Belichick should be shot.
I think that's a little strong.
Yeah, a little harsh.
That's hypothetical. Yeah, I mean, that's a hyperbole, rather.
Okay. Here are the players on the board.
With a camera.
We'll go in order of their ranking, not of how you threw them, because Tony Poljan is a fourth-ranked tight end.
No shot.
According to Lindy's. So I hope they're not taking a tight end that high. He's projected in the fourth round, though, so maybe it's a week. You have to get past Pitts. Apparently, there's not a lot of good tight ends. Anyway, strengths.
How big is he?
6'7", 265.
Ooh, good size guy.
Yep.
6'7". Wow.
6'7".
I like loose. It.
He shows steady acceleration off the ball, quickly reaching the second level and providing a massive target, I'd say. He collects the ball cleanly, exhibits soft, reliable hands.
He collects it cleanly from who? The equipment guys?
And uses his length to snatch the ball away from his frame. Okay, so all the stuff related to his height. Guess what his weakness is?
His speed.
His weakness. His height can get him in trouble.
How?
Well, his height can get him in trouble.
Tree fall hard.
When he allows his pad level to drop while blocking. His length allows him to catch blockers. Most cannot. However, And he should improve with greater strength and reps.
Wait a minute.
That's a poppycock.
His height works against him when his pad level gets too low.
Yeah.
This guy must go down like a ton of bricks. Seriously. Like what? He folds? People fold him or what? When he gets low?
I don't know. Okay, now here's the Brevin Jordan guy. Now is there an actual write-up on him?
Or? Where'd he go?
So no. Because
there's
he's
just
not
nothing on him?
No, so it's like usually these guys are ranked. Like the rankings are in Lindy's is Kyle Pitts is number one at the tight end position. Pat Freiermuth of Penn State's number two. Kerry Angeline's number three. This Poljan guy's number four. And then this Brevin Jordan is even listed. He's in a get to know box in the last page.
That's probably not good.
Okay, but he's projected in the third round, so I don't know why he's not in the regular, but whatever. Brevin Jordan. Jordan brought it in December. His regular season finale performance against North Carolina was dominant. 6 receptions, 140 yards, 76-yard TD.
Mm.
But the bowl game versus Oklahoma State shows the complete player in a 2-TD effort. And that bowl game, you'll be happy to know, is the 2020 Cheez-It Bowl.
Oh, I remember. And they poured all the Cheez-Its over the coach, too, at the end. It was great.
Okay, so put this guy on the board.
Yeah.
Hey, anyone who excels in the Cheez-It Bowl can play for me.
Patricia's yeah. going to love him.
He had 8 for 96 and 2 touchdowns in the Cheez-It.
In the Cheez-It Bowl. That sounds like a BC special right
there,
totally, man.
Oh, yeah, totally, yeah. And they probably lost it.
Yeah, the Acme Weed Whacker Bowl. That BC claim, you know, we're a bowl team, yeah.
This guy's listed at 6'3", 245.
Okay, so, yeah, 6'3", 245. Third round, put him on the board.
Get no shot.
I don't have
him.
A complete write up for you because he's not in the regular rankings. I don't get it. But and again, anyone who crushes it in the Cheez-It Bowl can play for me.
Yeah, Bill's gonna draft him, convert him to linebacker.
Here's Nick Eubanks, 6'5", 255 at the University of Michigan.
Ooh, he's good sized.
The traits are there as Eubanks is a wide bodied, long armed athlete.
Love it.
Octopus who looks the part.
Like he's a 747.
He moves well for his size with enough suddenness and change of direction ability to be able to create separation and present a big target in the middle of the field. He has enough speed to threaten the seam.
Huh.
Okay, why is this guy ranked
13th? I was just going to ask that.
This guy was ranked 13th in the Athlon thing. Okay, he flashes strong hands and has a big catch radius. Sounds perfect. What's his problem? Weak points. He too often lets the ball get into his frame.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
He'll lose a lot of contested catch situations at the NFL level.
So he's got the drops and he's not tough.
Frying pans for hands.
And he also often goes down on the first contact after the catch.
Oh, that blows for a guy that size.
For a big, solidly built tight end, he doesn't bring much at the point of attack in the run game.
I should have written these.
He will struggle to hold up in line. He projects in the 6th, 7th round. Nick,
that is right up their alley.
Put him on the board.
Yeah, absolutely. Perfect. 6th or 7th round, which means maybe even undrafted. Bring him in. He got something to work with. He's a lump of clay for Belichick. Maybe get something out of there because I fear the guys, 2 guys last year sucked.
Okay, we are counting down to the draft. We're counting down, hopefully, to the home stretch of the Jimmy Garoppolo discussion. Is he headed out of San Francisco in the next 2 days, and is he headed to New England? That's the lead story today. And also, we've hit on the receivers for the Patriots up high in the draft. Another prominent mock draft has the Patriots taken a receiver. This time, Jalen Waddle out of Alabama. That was from Chris Sims. Chris Sims had another pick that he gave in his mock draft that is a jumping off point for a whole nother discussion. I want to get to that in our long commercial free segment next.
Boston's home for sports. Felger Mazz.